In The Lord of the Rings, we first meet Galadriel in Lothlórien, and she appears alongside Celeborn, her husband, as one of the co-leaders of the forest and those elves who chose to stay with them. Now, not a lot of explained about the backstory of Galadriel in The Lord of the Rings. It's within the Silmarillion that we really dive into the intricacies of what defined her character and made her who she was in that setting, which was a very tempered individual with the wisdom of thousands of years and a different point of view than many of the other elves. She'd also been through a lot, seen the rise and fall of multiple factions and parties over the years, and ultimately was this sort of, I would say, regal queen-like character who ruled alongside Celeborn in a sort of pacifist manner. Now, granted, that's the book version, because the version that we've gotten in the show shows Galadriel as nothing more than a frickin' war criminal who's willing to commit genocide on top of all of the other atrocities that she's already done throughout the show. Episode 6 really showed us who she was. She showed her true colors, and it was cringeworthy. Like, I was like revolted and like, who is this Galadriel? I don't. You're threatening to kill and make him watch, make Adar watch. We're going to get into that today, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Tim Anderson, aka Renfell, the Bearded Dwarven Princess. And once again, we're back for another Rings of Power rant, talking about the things that drive me nuts about this show, and occasionally shining a light on things that are noteworthy and giving credit where credit is due. Before we dive into today's episode, as always, if you're new here, like, subscribe, hit the bell icon so you get updates on future content in the Rings of Power series, including the reviews of the episodes I do. And don't forget, every Monday morning at 11 a.m. Central Time, we do the Mondays in Middle-earth read-through as we go through The Hobbit, The Lord of the Rings, and The Silmarillion to reacquaint myself with the books that I last read 20 years ago, and to better analyze a lot of these story points that are being used in the Rings of Power show, however loosely they might be. And of course, don't forget to support the channel like all of these amazing people. Super simple. Join as a member of the Adventurers Guild down there. We do a lot of cool stuff for our members here on YouTube. You can also do a super chat or a sticker on live streams or premieres. And you can do a super thanks on videos like these by just going down there and clicking that button and choosing an amount to contribute to the channel. Hopefully, you'll do so. Keep me going because this is my 5th month in October 2022 of being a full-time content creator, thanks to all of you. Now, without further ado, let's dive into this idea of who Galadriel is. Now, there's an article I've got pulled up over at Screen Rant. Talks about why Galadriel didn't fight in the Rings of Power and the War of Wrath in the Rings of Power. So in the Rings of Power, she's this accomplished warrior, but it doesn't explain why. We just see her introduced as a child in her home of Valinor, and then very quickly, it describes the elves leaving the Blessed Realm to wage a retributive war in Middle-earth. When she's finally introduced as an adult, she's this determined warrior and commander who apparently has done amazing things in this war, but she didn't participate in the War of Wrath against Morgoth. Now, in the books, in the actual Silmarillion, and Unfinished Tales, which Amazon does not have the rights to adapt, she didn't actually fight in the War of Wrath because she didn't believe Morgoth could be defeated without the help of the Valar. Now, the Rings of Power completely skips all of those intricacies regarding the War of Wrath and why the elves fought or why some of them didn't fight. But ultimately, Galadriel and her husband Celeborn thought it would be a losing battle. And ultimately, they were right in the end, as the Valar did have to intervene for Morgoth to be cast down. But what's really the issue here is that the evolution of her character sort of divided from what was written in the Silmarillion, and they decided to create their own version of Galadriel, who is this warrior princess, which in and of itself is not that big of a deal. Because if you want to add some, unique little things to your character for your unique show that you have the rights to make because you've purchased those rights for $250 million, then by all means, but stay true to the spirit of the character, because at no point in time was Galadriel ever described in any of the book material that's out there as this vindictive individual who is just on a, all she cares about is vengeance. And the show knows that she is this character because she has even said over the past couple episodes that she was telling Halbrand, I think in episode 4 or 5, That she suspects the reason that her friend Elrond betrayed her and the king sent her away is because they recognized that that vengeance inside of her that had come to consume her was bringing her down this path that was making her so much like Sauron that they couldn't distinguish between the two. So she recognizes that she's fucking up. She recognizes that she has this evil within her, and yet she's somehow not. You know, she's self-conscious enough to recognize that, but she's not self-conscious enough to cast it aside. Then when we get to the interview, sorry, interrogation, my bad, the interrogation with Adar, and he's explaining to her that he killed Sauron and that her quest for vengeance is over. She doesn't want to accept that. Instead, she goes off on this rant about how the orcs are a perversion of all that is good in the world, and I'm going to make it my personal mission to kill all of them, slowly, painfully, and I'm going to make you watch. And only at the end, after you have suffered like I have suffered, am I going to then kill you. These are the acts of a war criminal. She is actively telling him that she's going to commit genocide, make him watch, and then at the end of it, she's going to kill him after he's suffered the same thing that she suffered. What are you talking? So the orcs, in the grand scheme of things, the orcs are not to blame for what happened to them. Even within the doctrine of the show, the orcs were elves that Morgoth corrupted. Adar is the first of these, and he's called the father, you know, of Uruks. So everything that came after him, but they are all in and of themselves orcs. Orcs, excuse me, or elves. They were at one point elves that were corrupted by Morgoth. So if Morgoth was the deciding factor, and Morgoth was the one who corrupted the elves to begin with and made them into the orcs that they are, how is it that Galadriel doesn't want to save them? Why is it that she thinks that they deserve to suffer when their actions, whatever those actions might have been, were the result of them being corrupted by a higher power who was controlling them, corrupting them, and creating them to be this thing that they are now? I don't understand where her motivations come from for being this war criminal-like character who wants to commit genocide, other than just setting her up to be some horrific character who maybe they're trying to give her a redemption arc later on at the end of the day so that, you know, she can shed this horrific past and become this amazing, you know, excuse me, amazing regal queen. But I just don't buy it at this point. All I'm seeing is a character who is so hell-bent on revenge that she's doing things that just don't make any sense. She's been around for a long time. She knows that Morgoth corrupted the orcs, corrupted the elves and turned them into orcs. And if she knows that she would know that they weren't in control of their own faculties and she wouldn't have this quest for vengeance to kill all the orcs. It just seems to be like as soon as she got word that, oh, I killed Sauron, your quest is now ended, she now goes, no, that can't happen. I'm going to create a brand new quest and I'm going to just take my hatred for Sauron and I'm going to make it all about the orcs now and I'm going to kill all the orcs because they deserve to suffer like I suffered watching my people get killed. It just doesn't make any sense. At the end of the day, Galadriel was never a genocidal maniac. She was never a war criminal. She was a regal queen who had been through some stuff, and she did have pride, definitely had pride, but you know, it was she didn't participate in the kinslaying. It's just, oh my God, I don't know where to begin, really, honestly. Love to hear your thoughts. I can't even talk right now. I'm so like, rah! This is a fun rant video because I'm learning more about Galadriel as I read more things that I didn't know. When I first read things 20, you know, first read The Hobbit when I was 5, Lord of the Rings when I was 7, Silmarillion was in my mid-teens, and I only read it, I think, twice up to the time I was 20 years old. So I'm 42 now. It's been 22 years since I've read the Silmarillion. I haven't even gotten to it yet because I'm still winding up the Two Towers. But I'm researching things on the internet and finding more about her character and learning more things about her that I never knew before. And the more I learn, the more I see that the Rings of Power adaptation of her is like the worst thing ever. I'm not seeing the woke crap that everybody else talks about. I'm just seeing a very poorly written character who's being given these reasons to have vengeance that make absolutely no sense when she's supposedly this self-conscious elf. Food for thought. Love to hear your thoughts, comments below. Like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, support in all the ways that I talked about at the beginning of the channel. And of course, don't forget we have a Patreon page for That World Behind Me. It's a fantastical world point-and-click game, book series, and a 5th edition tabletop setting. So hopefully we'll see you over there as well. Till the next video, everybody. Stay safe, happy watching. Stay tuned, because the review will be coming out soon. Cheers.